What is 5.1 home theater system and what does it really mean or what does it really refer to? Hello everyone, I am Tanmay Mehta, your home technology consultant at Touchwood Automations, and today I am going to speak everything related to 5.1 home theater system and what does it really stand for, why is it 5.1 and not something else. Now I know many of you would think that hey, I know this answer because you have 5 speakers and 1 woofer, but it's not just that. Each speaker has a specific job, has a specific purpose, and has got a specific location where you need to place the speakers so that you can get a desirable 5.1 channel surround sound experience. And we are going to talk everything about 5.1 today. Now, before we get started, I want to remind all of you to subscribe to our channel right here, right now, so that you and I can stay connected and I can create these kind of videos which will help you make better, wise and well informed decisions when it comes to buying anything and everything related to home technology industry. Now your subscription really makes a big difference because we have been getting tremendous responses from all of you, and I have been personally engaging with most of you over one-to-one conversations in the comments as well as with our team members so that we are there to help you make better decisions. Now I know 5.1 stands for 5 speakers and 1 woofer, but why does the woofer not come into the 5 speakers? Like, why don't we call it 6.0 or 6 channel home theater system? Well, the answer is you have got 5 main speakers which are delivering full range sound, which means that right from low frequency, mid frequency to the high frequency, all sorts of sound frequencies are coming out from these 5 main speakers, and that is why only these 5 speakers are considered as your 5 main channel. Now the woofer, the reason why it is denoted as 0.1 is because it is just emitting the low frequencies and it does not deliver your mid frequencies or your high frequency sound. And that is why, because it's a low frequency emitter, which is also referred as LFE, your woofer is not counted as the main channel or the main speaker, and we call it as 5.1. Now you know that there are 5 speakers and 1 woofer, but why do you need only 5 and why there are not more? Why is it not 4.1? Well, the answer is very simple, because in any given home theater standard design, you have basic 5.1, which is that you have 3 speakers in the front, 2 speakers in your surrounds, and then you have got 1 woofer, and together all this thing can actually create a desirable surround sound experience. Now we are going to talk about which are these 5 speakers, what are they called, what is their job, what is their purpose, and what is their specific location, so that you and I can both together create such amazing experiences in our homes, which will actually help us be a part of the scene or the movie or the content that we are actually watching. Now, the very first speaker that I'm going to start with is your center channel speaker, which we also refer to as the vocal speaker. The reason being, this center speaker is ideally located in the center of your TV or your projector screen. It can't be anywhere else, it has to be exactly in the center line of your TV or the projector screen. Now, what's the science behind this? Well, let me give you a very, very, a layman example. Let's say I'm standing here and I've got 5 people around me talking the same language or using the same words and speaking out. What is going to happen is, every person who is talking will have a different pitch, they will have a different tone, and eventually I am not able to understand what they are really speaking about. So imagine these 5 people talking together versus I have only one person talking to me and delivering that vocals. What happens is that one person's sound is being able to catch properly by my ears and I am able to understand it in more detail. Similarly, in a 5.1 channel surround system, the center speaker does the job of that vocal or that dialogue, and that is why it has to be ideally in the center of the screen, because the people that you see on the screen, the center speaker is ideally in the center of them, so that whatever they are speaking on the screen, the sound is also coming from the same area. Now, that's about the center speaker. What are the other speakers? Well, you have got 2 more speakers in the front, which is your front left speaker and the front right speaker. Now, your front left and the front right speaker are delivering the sound which is coming along in that content or in that scene, along with the vocals and along with the surround. Now, what are these typical sounds? It can be, let's say, I am watching a chase scene, a car chase scene, the car's engine sound or the car sound is actually coming out from this left and right speakers. Similarly, if I'm watching some shooting scene, then I have that gun sound which is coming, and that comes from this left and right channel speakers in the front. Now, where should you place them? These front two speakers, that is your left and the right speaker, ideally have to be on the left and the right hand side of the screen. And when I say that, it can't be very, very much away from the screen. It has to be a little closer to the screen. Because let's say if I'm watching that person or that scene on the screen, but the sound is coming from elsewhere, my brain is not going to synchronize the video and the audio together. And that is where I may not feel that I am also a part of that particular scene. And the whole idea of any home cinema experience is that, what is that experience? Well, basically it means that you should feel that you are part of that scene, what is happening, and that all the sounds, all, you know, are around you. And for that very reason, the left and the right speakers cannot be very, very far away from the screen. They have to be very, very near to the screen. Now, they cannot be very near in terms of, you know, having it right next to the center speaker, because there has to be some sort of gap between the center speaker and this left and the right speaker. Now, when I sit at a distance of 10 to 12 feet, and if my front left and right speakers are hardly 1 foot away from my center speaker, what happens in most of these cases is that my center speaker's dialogue is going to get overpowered by these two left and right speakers, and eventually I may not be able to hear the dialogues very, very clearly. Now, this is a very, very common symptom that has been observed when you buy a soundbar. Because in one box you have got all these three speakers combined together, and that is where in a installed surround sound system you have that flexibility of separating the left channel, the center channel and the right channel to some distance, which is good enough to give you that separation of the front sound. Now, the job, the purpose and the location, we have already discussed about these front speakers. Let us jump onto the surround speakers. For the surround speakers, there are two locations. One, it can be to your, you know, right angle sides, so it can be on the side walls, or it can be on the rear wall. Now, these are the two locations wherein you can have your surround speakers. We have also seen that many people also install surround sound in the ceiling, which to some extent is still okay, but if at all you have a provision to have them on the side or the surround walls, that would be a great location to have your surround sound. Now, the job of a surround sound or the surround speakers is to give you the background score. Now, what do we call as background score? Let's say if you are watching a scene wherein you have you are in the mountains, you know, then you have this wind breeze, which the air sound or that wind sound needs to come from that particular background speakers. Similarly, if there is a scene wherein you have a river flowing right, you know, in the backgrounds, that river water sound generally comes from this background speakers. Now, one of the common complaints that we have come across, particularly for surrounds, is when you watch a soap, a serial or a match, you don't really get the surround sound. Now, that is going to happen because most of this content is recorded in a two channel and they don't really have any background score. And that is the reason why you don't get any sound from these background speakers. So if you're watching a movie or nowadays a lot of documentaries and shows are also recorded in a 5.1 channel format, and these formats are the ideal ones to give you the background score or the surround sound very, very properly. Now, that's the job of the speaker. What is the purpose of the speakers? The purpose of the surround speaker is to make you feel that you are also part of that particular area or that particular location or in that particular scene, which means that if I'm watching a scene wherein, you know, the river is flowing right next to me, then I need to really feel it through these particular surround sound. And that is the exact purpose of this particular surround speakers, to make you feel that you are also part of that particular content that you are watching. Now, these are about these five speakers, but there's one more thing that is remaining, that is your woofer. Now, how to, you know, place a woofer or the ideal location for a woofer is a topic which is very, very vast, and it can't be just covered with one single video in this particular thing. So that is where I want all of you guys to subscribe to our channel and turn on the notifications, because you don't want to miss that particular special video which we are going to do about the woofer placement. Because woofer position is very, very critical, because as we said, woofer does not give any sound. which means that it does not need any fixed location. It can be kept anywhere in the room, but it has to be a good, the output from the woofer needs to actually give you that bass or punch properly, and that is where the location of the woofer really matters a lot. For now, I can just tell you that you can put it anywhere near your TV cabinet or next to your sofa, and that also can be a good desirable location for your woofer. The job and the purpose of the woofer is to give you that bass or that punch or that thump that you require when you're watching that scene. And that, my friend, together completes the 5.1 channel home theater system. Now, I know that there are many channels beyond 5.1 or below 5.1 as well. Like, you must have heard 2.1 channel. So 2.1 channel generally has a front left and front right speaker along with a woofer. A 5.1 has 5 speakers and 1 woofer. Then you have got 3.1.2, which has got 3 speakers in the front, 1 woofer, and then you have got the Dolby Atmos speakers. Now, the Dolby Atmos terminology stands from 3.1.2, it can go up to 7.2.4, 9.2.8, anything can happen with this particular terminology. And we are going to talk about it separately, but for this particular video, which is more dedicated about 5.1 channel, all this information will together help you understand that what is their purpose, job, and the location of this 5.1 speakers, and what does it really mean. If you have found this information valuable, don't forget to hit the like button. Also, if you want to stay updated with our videos, don't forget to subscribe and share this video to all your network who are looking for good 5.1 home theater systems, and you might have just provided them with a gold or a valuable information which they will thank you forever. So that's it from my end for this particular video. I, Tanmay Mehta, your home technology consultant, will continue to guide you and help you make better, well-informed and wise decisions when it comes to buying anything and everything related to home technology industry. And for those of you who want to stay connected with us, you can chat with our team members using the link below. And for those of you who have got any questions, feel free to use the comment section so that we can engage with you in the comment section as well. That's it from my end. Once again, I, Tanmay Mehta, your home technology consultant, will see you all in my next video. Thank you.